Hi, I'm Kim. You're watching Kim Wilson TV. My channel is dedicated to helping victims of narcissistic abuse get free and stay free. Deborah left a comment recently. Hi, Deborah. Thank you so much. I'm going to post it in the next tile, and I want to talk about this today. You know, once you've moved in with the narcissist, let me tell you, this is a real game changer. This creates such a volatile situation for victims. Somehow the narcissists always seem to end up with the lease in their name, the mortgage in their name, even if you're married to them. They seem to end up with this tremendous amount of control over victims' residency. I think so much of the information, you know, that we share with each other almost comes in the form of telepathy. Like when Deborah left that comment, oh my God, I just, this surge of emotion and this sense of dread had come over me. Oh my God, Deborah, have I been in your shoes? Let me tell you. And I've always referred to Trevor's place as a house of pain. I mean, this was just from the second I saw the house and stepped through the door. The energy was bad. The layout of the house was strange. I mean, it was just, and we renovated and renovated and renovated over the years, and you couldn't get it off of it. Like there was just something, I don't know how to even describe it. Like we'd be a block away approaching the house, and I would just get this feeling of dread come over me. Maybe because I felt trapped there, maybe because I knew that living with him in the house presented an opportunity for him to manipulate and control my life, to unsettle me, you know. And this is what's happening to Deborah right now. And my God, Deborah, have I been in your shoes, sister? I mean, talk about absolute manipulation at the core of a person's daily life. You know, there's so much insanity in the world, so much madness. And I always believe, like, when you go through your front door and you close that door, you should be in the safest place on earth, just shutting out, you know, all the other bullshit. And you should be in a place that's safe, that makes you feel stable, that makes you feel nurtured, you know, where the people you love gather, where your, you know, most beloved possessions are, where your photos are, you know, just that place of safety in a world gone mad, just that one spot. And the narcissist seems to know this instinctively and is constantly rocking the foundation of what should be a safe place for victims. Out of all the comments here at Kim Wilson TV, and there are thousands, I can remember two very distinctly that said, I got the narc out, or the narc, you know, finally left. But typically, you know, the house has to be sold to get them out, or victims are fleeing to shelters or their son's sofa, like I went to, with the clothes on their back. And somehow the narcissist seems to manipulate the residency where the victim is always vulnerable. You know, Trevor said the same thing to me many times. Well, if you don't like like it, you know, then just move out. Okay, let's think about that. You know, just move out. Okay, like presto, you know, it just doesn't work that way. If you're moving, you need boxes, you need tape, you need newspaper, you need wrapping material, you need crates for your artwork and, you know, anything wall mounted. You need trucks, you need manpower. Oh, and by the way, you need to pay a first and a last month's rent. I mean, you're going down for thousands, you know, absolutely thousands. And you can't just snap your fingers and make it happen. Shit's big, it's heavy, it's bulky. You know, half of us are beat up, tired, sick, confused, disorientated. I mean, it's one thing to show up to even rent a place, you know, shaking like a leaf and looking all beat the hell up. But it's something else when you consider the workload, maybe time off work, and the financial burden of this. Now, normal people get home and they lock out the danger. I'm not saying we're not normal, but we have an unusual circumstance. And when we close that front door behind us, we've locked the evil in with us. And many of us are in such a volatile, vulnerable housing situation. You know, I've really been thinking about this since I looked at Deb's comment. You know, it's a lot of work to move. And I remember the first time I moved out and I was in my own place, and the boys and I were happy. We'd gotten completely out of there and the house was really cute and we'd all decorated together. And next thing you know, I get a call from my landlord. I was renting this house in a town I'd moved to for work. Anyways, the landlord calls and says, "Hey, Kim, you know, you might have a stalker. Are you considering maybe an alarm, some cameras? I just got a call from this weird fucking guy," right? So anyways, the landlord was immediately onto it. But, you know, Deborah's comment really made me think about that. And as soon as Trevor lost control of my, you know, residential stability in his house of pain, he immediately transferred, you know, his attempt at control and manipulation to the new house. I mean, fortunately, the landlord was onto this idiot immediately. But when they can no longer control you, when they cannot even control your residency anymore, they try and control how people see you. And, you know, he'd said some really crappy things to this landlord, but I mean, I knew this family, so, you know, they weren't buying it. But could you imagine, under different circumstances, had I not known the people, you know, and all of a sudden they get this random phone call about their new tenant? I mean, their desperation to control people, you know, once they lose that control, they desperately need to control how other people see or perceive them. Okay, so I call the fool and I say, "Hey, Trev, did you call my new landlord?" And he says, "Well, yeah, I just want to make sure you didn't put your lease in my name." What? Like, did he not know they were doing a credit check? Why would I use his name? Like, it was absolute insanity. I couldn't get my head around that. Just like Deborah, I've got sons, I've got five of them, and initially the first few times I fled the house of pain, the boys were there with their buddies, there'd be 20 big strong guys, just get everything out of there really quick. Well, you know, do that a couple times and the kids are like, "Okay, Ma, here we go again," you know. So yeah, I really relate to every word Deborah said. I think for many of us, there's been a bit of a revolving door at home, moving out, coming back, moving out, coming back. Oh, goodness. I'd love to hear your thoughts and comments on this. Please share and let us know what your experience has been with the narcissist controlling, you know, our housing and just rocking that foundation of security that a home should provide for us. I'm Kim. You're watching Kim Wilson TV. Peace be with you guys. I hope you're having a great narc-free day.